There are several new features available in Excel for Office 365. Here are the top 10. Data types. You can reference geography and stock data in Excel using data types. For example, take a list of countries and highlight the list. Go to the Data tab, and you'll see the Data Types group. Click on Geography. You'll notice it creates an icon on the left of each country. That is a data card. So I'm going to click on the Show card for the United States, and you can see a set of data here for all kinds of statistics about that country. And at the very bottom, it tells you the location where the data is coming from. This is a linked reference to that data source and will stay updated anytime you refresh the data in the spreadsheet. Now it's a good idea to highlight the list and go to Insert and create a table. Now that you've created a table, you can add columns and select data elements from that card list. It pulls up the data for the capital. Click another data card. We can pick the GDP. How about another data card for area? For geographic data, this can be a country, it can be a city, state, territory, province, or other geographic information. But not only can you do geographic information, you can also do stock data. So let's take a look at that. Let's do the same thing with this data. Highlight it, pick stocks from the data types group. We'll also come back and highlight the group and change it to a table. Now you'll notice that with the data type for stocks, it actually found the stock symbol and filled it in. But now I can pick from the list and choose the 52-week high. Let's take the price. And you'll notice up here on the tab, there is a refresh option for external data. It does that automatically for table design. So I can refresh and it will update these prices real time. You can even reference this data anywhere else in your spreadsheet. For example, if I want to look up Amazon's high for the day, I can put in equals, select Amazon, put a period in, and then look at the high. And you have the daily high for today. These data types are very handy, and you can expect that over time, Microsoft will add additional data types to the list with linked data to their source. Recommended pivot tables. Pivot tables are useful to summarize sets of data. Excel now has a recommended pivot table option that gives you a jump start on common pivot table designs. Just click anywhere in the table and go to the Insert tab and select recommended pivot tables from the list. It pops up a variety of pivot table designs based on the data. You can see that it has the sum of total by region, sum of total by rep, sum of total by product. And all you have to do is select the one that makes the most sense, hit OK, and it creates a new sheet with your pivot table. And now you can edit the pivot table and make adjustments however you want. The recommended pivot table gives you a quick way to create standard types of pivot tables without having to manually create them from scratch, and is available from the menu with one button. XLOOKUP function. XLOOKUP is an improvement over VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP functions. It's the most anticipated new feature for Excel in 2019. XLOOKUP allows you to find data in a list and return values from the associated column or row. Let's say we want to do an XLOOKUP to find the name Sally in this list and return the values from this list. You can see that it found Sally and returned $540. That's very similar to the VLOOKUP function. But the nice thing about XLOOKUP is you can do a horizontal lookup as well. So let's find product in this list and return the values from the row for Sally. And you can see it shows A1, which is the intersection of product and Sally. Another feature of XLOOKUP that is not available with VLOOKUP is doing negative columns. So let's say we wanted to find A1 in this list, but we want to return the value for the rep from this list. It finds the first A1 and returns the value Jim. That goes back to columns, which is not something you can do with the VLOOKUP function. Another feature of XLOOKUP, let's look up Sally again in this list, but the value we're going to return is the entire list. And you can see what it did is it found Sally in the list and returned the entire row of data, and it actually spans over multiple columns. So that's one of the benefits of the XLOOKUP function. It can replace the index match combination as well as HLOOKUP and VLOOKUP. And from this point forward with Excel, you shouldn't need to use any of those other functions. Just use XLOOKUP for everything. This is just a quick summary of the XLOOKUP function. If you want a deeper dive, make sure to take a look at the Excel XLOOKUP video dedicated to just that topic. Ideas. Excel can analyze your data to detect trends and patterns with ideas, and it's super simple to use. Just click inside of a table of data that you have, and on the Home tab, click this lightning bolt for ideas. It brings up a task pane with a bunch of recommended summaries, rankings, and correlations. And these are very interesting. This one shows the amount by product. This one finds that there is a quantity and total correlation, which makes sense because quantity times the amount is the total. But it gives you a nice graph to represent that data correlation. And it notices for product B2, George and John have noticeably higher totals. You can see down here there are 32 results, so let's show more. It detects that Tom's region for South has the majority of the total dollars and the majority of quantities. You can get an idea of all the different things that it can detect from your data. Pick one that you like and insert a pivot chart into your spreadsheet. It brings up an idea sheet and inserts the pivot table with the chart. Ideas uses AI to look for patterns in your data that show outliers, trends, higher rankings, or correlations worth highlighting. The more detailed real-world data you provide, the more interesting the results. Funnel charts. Newly added for 2019 is funnel charts. If you have data that fits nicely into a funnel chart, just click somewhere in the data, go to the Insert tab, and in the Charts group, click the arrow and scroll down until you see a funnel chart. Hit OK, and you've just created a funnel chart from your data. It works best if you sort the data so that you get the traditional funnel look. And then once your chart is created, you can use all the normal editing options for charts, including selecting a standard layout and adjusting colors and fonts within the chart as you need. And it's as simple as that. Get add-ins. All Office 365 apps now have a new option called Get Add-ins. You go to the Insert tab and click on this Get Add-ins button. It's not the same thing as the old File Options add-ins, where you load an add-in file into Excel. Instead, when you click the Get Add-ins button, it brings up the Office add-ins window, where you'll find thousands of add-ins available for Excel. Some of them are similar to previous ones, like Solver. This was available as an add-in to Excel previously, but now when you click Add, it lets you install Solver directly into Excel. The Get Add-ins gives you thousands of free and purchased add-ins to install in Excel. Be sure to check out my top 10 free Excel add-ins video when it becomes available. Switch function. The new switch function switches one value for a corresponding value in a list. It's a quick way to substitute values without having to create tables or complex if statements. For example, if we have some dates, we can use the switch function to take the weekday of that date and look it up in a list. If it's a weekday with one, then we want it to be Sunday. If it's a weekday two, then we want it to be Monday. Three, Tuesday. And if there is no matching value, then we'll just say no match. And as you can see, it detected Monday, Tuesday, and we didn't do Wednesday, so there's no match. You can use up to 126 values in the list to handle just about any complexity. Live collaboration. One of the great work team features available in Excel for Office 365 is live collaboration. It allows you to share a spreadsheet with other team members and see each other's changes in real time. All you do is click on the share button in the upper right corner and enter the name of the person that you want to send it to or an email address of somebody that you want to forward the email. You can also click this copy link option and copy that link and send it to somebody via email. You can choose the option to allow them to edit or turn that off. And you can set an expiration date and a password. Once that's done, you apply that setting and send the link. The other person opens up the email and you can see a cursor where they're working on your spreadsheet. If they change the values, those values change on your screen as well. Hover over their colored cell location and you can see the name of the person that's doing the collaboration with you. You can share with as many people as you want to and have everyone working on the same spreadsheet at the same time. 3D maps. Take your location-related data to the next level using 3D maps. Let's say we want to map the population for all US states. I have a table with this data. Click anywhere in the table, go to Insert, and choose 3D map. Then open 3D maps. It brings up a 3D map of the world and adds the state field to the location for you automatically. We're going to take the population and put it in the height field. And now we can zoom in to parts of this map and see the data up close. You can also type in a find location and it'll take you directly to that particular state. You can make it a flat map or switch it back to 3D. You can turn on map labels, which will show all the state names. You can also refresh the data if there's changes to the numbers. And you can choose from different chart types: bubble, heat map, or region to get the look the way you want it. All this information is collected into a video tour of your 3D map. Combine it with time-based changes to your data, and you can watch data grow or shrink based on those changes. Once everything's set, you can close this window. It adds a 3D map tours notification and reminds you that you can click on the 3D maps in order to view your tours. When you do, it lists all the tours you have available in the spreadsheet, and you can select the one that you want to play. And as expected, the more data you provide, the more detailed 3D maps you can create. Natural language query. Microsoft just announced the addition of a natural language query. This new feature will be added to the Ideas window in Excel. You'll be able to type a question asking Excel about your data, and it will provide a chart of the results. It's so new, I still don't even have the option available in my preview version of Excel, but it's coming in 2020. You'll see it here under the Ideas, and there'll be an area right here where you can enter your question. Stay tuned for more. Hey, if you want to see more videos like this one, please subscribe. And if you've enjoyed this video, be sure to click the thumbs up and leave a comment. I really do appreciate your support.